Ina Simone is retired, a mother and grandmother from Russia who now lives outside of Boston. Last November, her home computer started acting strangely.
My computer was working terribly. It was not working. I mean, it was so slow.
A few days later, while searching through her computer, Ina saw dozens of these messages. They were all the same. They read, "Your files are encrypted. To get the key to decrypt them, you have to pay $500. Her exact deadline, December 2nd at 12:48 p.m., was just a few days away. All her files were locked. Tax returns, financial papers, letters, even the precious photos of her granddaughter Zoe. Ina couldn't open any of them.
It says, if you won't pay, your fine will double. If you won't pay by then, all your files will be deleted and you will lose them forever and never will get back."
Ina Simone, like hundreds of thousands of others, had been victimized by what's known as a ransomware attack. Hackers, who law enforcement believe often come from Eastern Europe or Russia, managed to put malicious software onto a victim's computer, often via an email attachment or a compromised website. That software then allows the hackers to lock up your files or your entire computer until you pay them a ransom to give it back. Ransom demands have ranged anywhere from a few $100 to several hundred thousand. Justin Kapos is a computer security expert at New York University.
It will actually lock you out of the files, the data on your computer. So you'll be able to use the computer, but those files have been encrypted by the attacker with a key that only they possess. It's frustrating because you know the data is there. You know the files are there. You know your photos and everything is there and could be accessible to you, but you have no way of being able to get at it because of this encryption that the attackers are using.
Ina was panicked. Computer technicians were no help. She didn't want to call the police. Her husband at first said, "Don't pay the ransom," but she wanted those files back. In their ransom note, the hackers wanted to be paid in Bitcoin, the largely untraceable digital currency, and to have it put into their anonymous account. Ina had never heard of Bitcoin, but the hackers, in one of their many touches of what you might call customer service, provided all sorts of helpful facts and links and how-to guides about Bitcoin. Alina Simone is Ina's daughter.
If you see the ransom note, you can see, they try to reassure you about Bitcoin. Like, we've got screenshots, or, you know, here's a link to some kind of a guide that talks you through the whole process, and here's a list of providers with little kind of Yelp-like reviews next to each one that kind of explains their strengths and weaknesses. It's incredibly sophisticated.
Enough?
After days of debate, Ina decided to pay. She sent a money order to a Bitcoin seller, but it was Thanksgiving week, and a huge snowstorm hit Boston, which meant her check only arrived the afternoon before her deadline. And in that delay, Bitcoin's exchange rate changed, and now her check didn't cover the full $500 ransom. It was about $13 short. Her last resort was this Bitcoin ATM in Brooklyn, New York, conveniently not far from her daughter Alina's apartment.
It's a very kind of spooky looking ATM. It has no buttons. It just has a slot that you feed your money into.
Tuesday afternoon, the full ransom was sent to the hacker's account, but it was 2 hours late. Ina added one short message with her payment.
I wrote, "I wish you all will drop dead."
The FBI doesn't have complete data on how often these attacks occur. Computer security researchers estimate close to 1 million users have been hit globally during the last year. One tech firm estimated that more than a quarter of the victims pay the ransom, which many cybersecurity experts discourage because they don't want to encourage more hacking.
Our information was held hostage.
Critical files.
And it's not just individuals who get hit. Hackers have hit several local police stations. We heard of law firms being targeted. Even the city of Detroit had its data held for an $800,000 ransom by hackers. The city didn't pay.
When you think of a technology hack, you think of data that's being, data or files that are being destroyed or taken. Ransomware, I learned, doesn't work that way.
Last month, Terry Van Zoren had to learn all about ransomware when his Southern New Jersey school district got hit. Hackers compromised the entire district's computer system, causing problems with hard drives through several schools, administrators' computers, those in the classrooms, the computers that processed kids' lunch payments, even the ones that ran the standardized tests that were going on when the hack occurred.
We had to shut down student testing for a number of days until we got control of the PCs, and there were hundreds of them within the district.
Van Zoren said the hackers demanded 500 Bitcoin, which at the time was about $128,000 in ransom. School officials didn't pay. There's obviously no guarantee paying up gets your data back. Instead, they called the police. School officials said no student or parent data was stolen, and after a costly, elaborate rebuilding of their network, they were able to get back up and running. NYU computer scientist Justin Capo says hackers go after such seemingly small targets because they're pretty easy. Victims often inadvertently download the viruses themselves by clicking on those email attachments. Besides, he says, the risks of getting caught are low, and if you cast a wide enough net, you'll get something.
When you go fishing, you don't try to catch every fish in the ocean. You only want to catch some. And if you catch enough of them, then it's been a profitable trip for you.
When her mom got hacked, Alina Simone, who's a journalist by day, did some research into ransomware for a piece she wrote for the New York Times. She says it's alarming how organized and easy it is to carry out these kinds of computer attacks.
There are people making viruses, selling viruses. There are distributors whose specialty is distributing viruses. These perpetrators, they don't have to know a line of code. They can just buy a virus and then hire a distributor and send it out. And it's kind of just an off-the-shelf, you know,
God. Plug-and-play corruption.
Right, yeah. And so that's sort of the scariest thing. That just one person can just unleash all of this chaos and malice on the world with very little effort.
Her mom's story, however, wasn't over. Ina had paid the hackers her $500, but rather than releasing her files as promised, they sent her this message. It said, "You did not pay in time for decryption." Remember, she'd paid 2 hours late. Now the hackers doubled the ransom to $1,000, gave her another deadline, and said if she missed this one, they would delete everything.
If you won't pay by then, all your files are gone forever.
Using a message board the hackers provided, another one of those customer-friendly touches, Ina pleaded with the people she'd previously told to drop dead. "We had a snowstorm," she wrote. "It was a holiday. I'm only 2 hours late."
So first I sent them about all these obstacles and the fact that I was only 2 hours late, and this is really harsh.
Did this feel strange that you're trying to communicate to a group of criminals, who knows where they are in the world, saying, "You don't understand, the post office, the snow, Thanksgiving, a long weekend"? I mean, you must have felt...
But what else? This is the only option. It's either this or nothing.
You didn't know if it would work.
Absolutely not.
But later that day, the hackers released her files in full.